Hi guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me for another Royal News video. So you've got a weekend video from me, which is always a bit of a rarity, but there's so much stuff going on. I've got to keep these videos coming out thick and fast to stay on top of it. I told you I'm all refreshed and relaxed from having a couple of holidays. So to start with some good news from the Royals, and then we're gonna have them in the middle, and then we're gonna finish with some more good and amazing Royal News. So we're going to start today with the lovely Princess Royal, Princess Anne, who is back to doing her duties after suffering a very severe concussion. I think she was kicked in the head by a horse, which left her hospitalised for 5 days. It must have been quite the nasty knockout, as it were, but as I said, horses are very, very strong animals, and she is 73, but she's a trooper. Princess Anne attended the Riding for the Disabled Association, the shorter version is called the RDA, National Championships in Gloucestershire. The association was celebrating its 55th anniversary, of which the Princess Royal has been patron of since 1971 and president of since 1986. The RDA benefits the lives of over 20,000 disabled children and adults. It provides skills, therapy, fitness, development. It enables children and adults to make lots of new friends. And most importantly, it is about having fun with some of the most beautiful creatures that we've been lucky enough to have on this earth with us. So in more great news, we have just been told today that the Princess of Wales, Princess Catherine, is actually going to be handing over the trophies at the men's Wimbledon final, the championship. The final is tomorrow and she will be in attendance. So we're all very excited to see her back. I think the happiness we've seen coming from Prince William recently, I think she's really turned a corner. And of course, she will no doubt break the internet. Now, in something that it's kind of been trending, but all for the wrong reasons, and this is, of course, the ESPYs. Now, I know some of you must be sick of it by now, hearing all about it, but I'm going to give a different twist on it. The thing is that Harry and Meghan love to do is to control this perfect image, this perfect narrative. I think that their teams of staff, their PR staff, would probably be able to get themselves a decent job in North Korea, because they put out so much positive propaganda and it's all the same media outlets. And anybody would think that the veterans were crying on stage for Harry as he collected his award. There were standing ovations for Harry. Everybody was happy that he was there. And the downfall at every event like this for Harry and Meghan is people are allowed mobile phones and people take photographs and footage and upload it to social media, and it tells a very, very different story. Now, obviously, we knew that Harry was not going to turn down this award, because if he was going to do the right thing, he would have done it some time ago. So it was clearly obvious that he was going to be there. And it was also very clearly obvious that Meghan was going to be done up to the nines and be happily posing along the red carpet, much like it would be her event. Voila, we have this. But look at the body language. Look at Meghan with Serena, all happy and lovely. Look at Harry with Serena. They look like that they're very good friends. Throw Meghan into the mix and the claw into the mix. Look at the body language of Harry and Serena. It's quite the difference. I honestly do not feel that salt and pepper are moving together as happily as they once were. So let's talk about Meghan's outfit just briefly. As you know, I'm always very fair with Meghan, and I thought that she did look beautiful with some lovely photographs of her. The dress is very similar to a lot of dresses we've seen her wear, including one that she wore as her second wedding dress by Stella McCartney on her wedding day. She did look lovely. I don't like the hairstyle. I think she looks much prettier when she wears her hair down. This I find too harsh on her face and her features. But again, look in this photograph, Meghan with her normal Cheshire cat that caught the canary grin. Notice something different with Harry. His body is slightly twisted away from her. He's not holding her hand, so she's got her hand clamped to her trophy. Sorry, her husband's knee. It's making it very clear. It's almost like Meghan is getting very territorial, like we saw earlier with Serena. She has to hang on to him like a limpet. Now, as for Harry and Meghan sitting there in their seats, they snuck in, which honestly, I'm not shocked at or surprised at, because obviously we knew there was going to be a lot of backlash. There was a very good chance that they would be booed outside. And of course, Meghan cannot have that for her brand. Now, Serena kicked this off by obviously being the host, but she made a point which triggered some people, myself included. She made a point about saying how royalty are here. I've got lots of clips that I'm going to play to you. You can hear it yourself.
Actually, only pretty often that I get to be in a room with actual royalty. And tonight is no exception. Prince Harry and Meghan are here.
I did notice there was no use of the Duchess of Sussex, which is very unusual. But Harry's face doesn't look too happy, considering he and Serena are obviously very chummy with each other and they work on Better Up together as well. In fact, Harry's face is sour pretty much throughout this entire evening that he was briefly there. And I think that's because he got booed when he came in there. There were so many of them, people were bound to quickly sneak in a boo. Now, as for Harry going up on stage to collect his awards, this is where Meghan, you knew that she was desperate to have some limelight herself, because they announced, there were several veterans on stage, and they announced that this is Prince Harry, you know, come up and collect your award. Now, you see the brief clip here, then you see the stills of what actually happened. Meghan was initially clapping, look, and then she grabs hold of Harry, she double hand grabs hold of him, and she's hanging on to him. I think personally, in this moment, she either wanted him to grab her and take her up on stage with him, or she was trying to pull him back so he would lean back and give her a kiss, because a nice Hollywood kiss between them, all for the cameras, it would have been perfect again for their brand. Harry did not lean back and kiss his wife. In fact, he didn't even look back at his wife as she desperately clung to him, again like a limpet. In fact, he didn't even mention Meghan once in his speech. But then they've had to change it. Remember, it wasn't an award for Prince Harry, it was an award for Invictus. Now, as Harry was getting up, ignore the fact that we have a very different view of Harry's head to what the magazines like to print. But look around, look at people's faces here. You can see that nobody looks impressed. Not only that, I'm going to slow-mo so much of this for you. Notice the crowd. Meghan gets up, a few people get up, and it starts like a Mexican wave. But there is one person who clearly does not get up. In fact, she had been staring at Meghan several times throughout the evening, and she is now trending on social media. And that is, of course, Serena Williams' sister, Venus, who I have to say looked absolutely stunning. That green silk dress was beautiful. Perhaps Venus was just merely staring at Meghan's dress because, as someone pointed out on Twitter, Venus had been wearing a very, very similar dress at an event, I think, 2 weeks previously. She does not look impressed in the slightest, which matches with the majority of people's faces throughout. So Harry lets out this big puff of air, not looking quite like the big confident man there to collect his trophy. And he hugs the veterans that were already on stage, Elizabeth, Israel and Kirsty, who have also competed in the Invictus Games. Well, they then walk off after they've handed him the award, and Harry tells them to come back. But listen to the way he asks them to come back. It's more of a command.
Whoa, come back. Come back, you guys got to stay here for me.
whoa, you guys have got to stay here for me. It's not stay here with me, you know, accept the award altogether. It was very much a command. He then follows it up again when he says,
stay here, you need to be with me.
You need to be with me. That to me is a Freudian slip. That's him saying, no, you have to be here for me. And I'll tell you why. I don't need to tell you why. You know why. He's got them there as a buffer, as a shield, because he knows he's got a lot of angry and upset faces staring at him whilst he's about to get this award, which, as we know, huge, huge backlash. I think, honestly, all three of them were asked to stay on that stage so Harry had that kind of support behind him. Because remember, they then shifted it from being the award for Prince Harry to actually to go towards veterans. Harry actually needed veterans on the stage for that to look even a teeny tiny bit believable. So let's start with his speech.
Thank you, Elizabeth, Israel and Kirsty. Stay here. You need to be with me. I'd like to begin by expressing my deepest gratitude to everyone at the Pat Tillman Foundation, led by Marie Tillman Shenton, who I'm so honoured is here tonight.
So a nod to Marie Tillman, who is the founder of the Tillman Foundation. She doesn't look too happy, does she? Well, why would she? It's pretty obvious that Harry has attracted so much negative attention by being a recipient of this award that I'd imagine a foundation that gets most of its money from donations has had somewhat of a strong financial hit due to people's outpouring of disgust of the Pat Tillman Award being given to Harry.
I'd also like to acknowledge the Tillman family, especially Mrs. Mary Tillman, Pat's mother. Her advocacy for Pat's legacy is deeply personal and one that I respect.
I respect Mary Tillman so much that she didn't want me to get this award, but thanks, Mary, I respect you. Clearly, Harry, you don't.
The bond between a mother and son is eternal and transcends even the greatest losses.
Come on, that had nothing to do as a message for Mary, for her son. That was all about Harry going, don't anybody forget that, you know, I'm Diana's son and I lost my mum. That's exactly what that was. Of course he was going to pull the Diana card.
The truth is, I stand here not as Prince Harry Pat Tillman Award recipient, but rather a voice on behalf of the Invictus Games Foundation.
So, Harry has made a point of saying, the truth is, I'm not here as Prince Harry, the recipient of the Pat Tillman Award. Well, quite clearly, Harry, you are. And if that award was genuinely for Invictus and all of the veterans, then why did you feel the need to say the truth is? It's very obvious that they have done a little bit of damage control trying to make it out that this is for the Invictus Foundation and not Harry specifically.
This award belongs to them, not to me.
Now, at that point, that would have been the perfect time to end it, wouldn't it? I think he's done a long enough speech. He's got people on stage. He's got his trophy. That would have been the time to say, thank you, everybody. This is for Invictus and toddle off. But he doesn't. Now, this is where Harry starts changing his tone. Like I've said before, this is the boring, depressing. It's not an inspiring speech.
For those who may not know, Invictus comes from Latin, meaning undefeated or unconquerable. Nelson Mandela credited the poem of the same name, written by the poet William Ernest Henley, for giving him the strength to endure nearly 30 years of imprisonment.
Quoting Latin, he's talking about Nelson Mandela. We know who wrote this speech. You can hear her voice because it's very similar to actually the speech that he read out on Nelson Mandela's day, if you remember the success of that.
Like that poem, the spirit of the Invictus Games transcends race, time, and borders. It is born from unity and exudes purpose. This year, we're celebrating 10 years of witnessing life-changing impact and healing through sport.
So here's the perfect opportunity to end it now. Even the lady in the red dress, she is now at a point where she's walking across to her friends and Harry continues. He had the perfect time to end it, but no, he's going to keep going.
And while so much progress has been made since those first games, the world outside seems to be in an even more precarious state. We live in an age marked by polarization and division. Conflicts rage around the globe. Anger and resentment towards those who are different seem to pervade societies everywhere.
Our community proves that unity is not just possible, but formidable. The beauty of the Invictus Games lies in how it brings people together.
Sorry, I felt like that you guys had heard enough. Yes, he did get a round of applause, but again, it's people's faces. Now, not only is it the audience's faces here, Harry's face gives something away as he's walking off the stage. The veterans are just walking in front of him. Look at Harry, look at his trophy with that big, goofy grin on his face. Then he spots the cameraman and then he looks almost for a second like, oh shit, I'm meant to look a little bit humble here. Wouldn't it have looked so much better if, considering Harry said the award is not for him, he actually gave it to the veterans on stage and did his speech going, it's not for me, it's for people like these guys. It's for all of you that are here. But he didn't. He hung on to his prize. And as I said, that moment where he's grinning down at it like an idiot and then goes, oh yeah, yeah, I meant to look a little bit grateful, aren't I? Unbelievable. He's got as many mask slips now as Meghan does. Now, this is where I think they did the jerkiest thing. They were a pair of jerks. They got up and decided to leave. Like they snuck in, they decided to leave early. So the event is still happening. Now, Harry and Meghan had front row seats. Of course they did. But Harry and Meghan also took in a ridiculous entourage. They had security, they had staff. You remember this lady? You might recognize her face. She was one of my favorite members of their staff. She's the one that got given the job of trying to shove Meghan along the carpet when Meghan was hogging the carpet at the Variety Power of Women event last November. But obviously she's learned her lesson not to shove Meghan again. But look at the hassle that they're causing. People are sitting in their seats. The host is still talking. The event is still ongoing. They're hugging people. They're shaking people's hands. Bearing in mind, people are still trying to watch the show. Now, this bit, this is one of my favorite bits of the clip. Meghan and Harry are now leaving finally with their huge entourage after spending 5 minutes being probably a complete nuisance and disturbance to everybody else. Nobody is clapping them. People aren't even looking at them. Meghan hasn't got fans screaming, "We love you, Meghan. Thank you for your service, Meghan," as they fall to their knees and cry. Nobody is looking at them. No one is clapping at them. If anything, they are just completely blanking them, bar one person at the end that shakes Meghan's hand. But it's the way Meghan's sachets up the carpet. Look at that. She looks like she's popped her hip out the socket. It reminds me of how she walked up the garden steps of Charles's Buckingham Palace garden party, if you remember. It's that old hip sachet. And I'm sorry, I just think those two just look like a pair of Muppets. They snuck in, they snuck out to avoid the boos. And as I said, that big entourage that just did nothing apart from cause chaos, who do they think they are? I think, honestly, the President and the First Lady could have gone there and been more discreet out of respect for the other people in the audience and the host and for the event in general. Harry should never have accepted the award. He should have politely turned it down. But his speech, for me, I'm sorry, I've listened to it more times than I care to mention, and it was a tick box of crisis management. It was little more than every major complaint that's gone out against Harry, he made sure he ticked, including Mary Tillman, who is Pat Tillman's mother. But I think the way he mentioned her and then quickly flipped it round to a comment about his mother, which everybody knows, everybody translated it, he was referring to the fact, don't forget Diana's my mother and she died when I was 12 years old. It's that old pull at the heartstrings, something that is favoured by Meghan. That's why, remember, she wrote the Dear Daddy. While she always called him Daddy, she knew the way she wrote that letter, it would pull at the heartstrings of the public because she always wanted it to go public. Meghan has got her fingerprints all over Harry's speech. They were both cowards, the fact that they snuck in there, and I think they were both incredibly rude, the fact that they still went ahead and collected this award to then leave half hour early and disturb everyone like that as she sashayed out like the Queen of Sheba. Now that's enough of them. Let's go on to the other side of the Atlantic to everybody's favourite brother who has just won a trophy. But unlike Harry, it's not for himself. It's actually for a great cause, a team effort, and it's raising millions for multiple charities. Yes, old Big Willie is back riding his polo pony, and what a sight it was with the incredible backdrop of Great Windsor Park. Prince William is a talented horse rider. His horses never ever look distressed. He certainly never made them bleed by wearing spurs on his boots. He is a very, very fit sportsman in multiple ways. And I will say, I'm sure that the temperature in Windsor went up a few degrees higher than the rest of the nation. And not only that, can we just say, whose idea was it to stick the monogram there? You could be like, no, officer, I was clearly just trying to see what the coronet sits above, honestly. Now, the Prince of Wales was competing in the Outsourcing Inc. Royal Charity Polo Cup 2024 at the Guards Polo Club in Windsor. This is the 13th year that he has played for it, and every single year it raises over £1 million, which is evenly distributed to charities that he and Catherine support. This particular match was held in honour of rugby legend Rob Burrow, who sadly lost his fight with motor neurone disease in June last month. Rob was a legend, not just only on the pitch, but also off, especially due to his fundraising and campaigning to raise awareness of the disease. And he had received an MBE alongside his friend and rugby star Kevin Sinfield back in January. The MND Association, which Princess Anne is a patron of, and of course will be one of the charities that benefits from this latest £1 million polo fundraiser. Now, while we're on the themes of trophies, as I said, I'm super excited about the fact that we're going to see the Princess of Wales tomorrow handing out the trophy at the Men's Championship Finals. It's going to be lovely to see her. Very, very exciting. But I think another thing regarding a trophy is going to be on everybody's lips in England and Spain, to be fair, tomorrow. This is huge. This is so big because England has only ever made it to the European Championship Finals twice. This is the second time. This is big. And nobody jinx it. Nobody say it's coming. No, we don't want to hear that. It is bad juju. At 8 p.m. tomorrow, England and Spain will be screaming at our TVs, across pubs, across homes, across sports fields. Both countries will be holding our breath and hoping that we are the ones that take home the trophy. But I will finish the video with a message from King Charles, or at least a little bit of it, which was to Gareth Southgate and, of course, the England team. And he said, "If I may encourage you to secure victory before any last minute wonder goals or penalties drama for the nation's blood pressures and our heart rates." And as much as I get what he was trying to say, where's the fun in that? So for everybody watching the England and Spain game tomorrow, may the best team win. So guys, I will see you on the other side of this, and I may or may not have a voice come Monday, Tuesday. Take care for now. See you soon. Bye.